Okay, so list A contributory, list B contributory. List A contributory are present shareholders who hold the shares for a period of 6 months out of 18 months. Okay, in last 1 year before the winding up. Or list B contributory. So present shareholders are list A contributory and the last 1 year people who sold the shares to the present contributors are list B contributory. Correct?
List B contributories.
Then 286 obligations for the directors and managers. So what it says, in case if your memorandum, okay, it says that the limit, the liability of the directors are unlimited. In case if the memorandum says what, the liability of the directors are unlimited, then not only as a member they are liable, okay, but also as a director they are liable. Please understand, there are two types of liabilities. Saikiran.
Yes sir.
Purunjitha, there are two types of liabilities. One is as a member you are having one liability which is limited. Some company through its memorandum for directors alone they will have unlimited liability.
Yes.
Can you understand?
Yes sir.
Okay. So they have to pay that amount. Come on, Sai, tell me about advisory committee.
Sir, advisory committee comes under section 287. It shall be consist of 12 members having creditors and contributories.
Okay. Then, whether.
What's the purpose of this advisory committee?
See, advisory committee, there are 2-3 committees actually. Winding up committee. Okay. Winding up committee, la, they won't have members, correct? But advisory committee, they will include members. Can you able to understand?
Yes, sir.
These people will support the members. Basically, winding up committee, the members will not be there, but advisory committee, the members will be there.
Okay.
See, otherwise, creditors will sell the assets only in their point of view, right? Ma, 1 crore rupees asset irukuma, okay? 1 crore rupees ka liability irukku, okay? 1 crore rupees shareholders irukanga, okay? If you give the assets, the creditor will sell in such a way that only they will get settled. They will never think of shareholders.
Okay.
That is why there will be one committee which will be including the shareholders also.
Then what is the difference between this committee and the stakeholder
committee? Stakeholder relationship committee will be in the going concern time. And stakeholder relationship committee is only applicable for public limited companies having 1000 shareholders. That is going concern. This is
winding
up. Then, powers and duties of company liquidator. Come on, tell me. Sai.
Sir.
Powers and duties of liquidator.
Powers and duties. To sell the whole undertaking of the
first company. First of all, they will run the company for some time.
Sir?
They will run the company for some time.
Yes, sir. And then to sue anyone.
So, first they will run the company, they will carry on the business, possibly. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Then they will sell the assets. Okay?
In case
settle the claims.
Persons who are against the company, they can be sued, sir.
Yeah, sue, yes, exactly. Then?
And then they can invite and settle the claim of the creditors.
Okay.
They can take professional assistance. CA, CMA, CS as well as legal advisors.
Okay, very good. Then so who is now responsible to maintain the books of accounts and all?
It's the responsibility of a liquidator, sir.
Okay, they have to maintain the minutes also. Who is responsible for getting the books of accounts audited?
There is also, sir.
Liquidators, correct? So you should maintain the books, you should get it audited. You should conduct general meeting.
Replaced by the directors, sir.
Exactly. So he will be allowing the creditors and members who are doing inspection. He will be filing with ROCs. See, during winding up, okay, it is not a one day process. It may take more than a year or 2 years also. So till that time, you have to conduct general meeting, get it audited, file with ROC. And here, one more thing, you have to give a copy to tribunal also.
class.
Previously, you should give OP only to ROC, no? AOC 4, yes, MDT 7 and all, you give only to ROC. But here, you have to give to tribunal also. That is only extra thing.
Yes,
okay, then.
Government company to the government.
Exactly, if it is a government company, you should give it to the government. Come on, tell me, I should have put 295. சூப்பர் இதுதான் இது நான் வந்து கிளாஸே கேன்சல் பண்ணி அனுப்பிச்சு விட்டேன் போய் படிச்சுட்டு வாங்கன்ட்டு அஸ்வின் குருவில்லா கமன் டெல் மீ வாட் இஸ் 295 சரி சொல்லு வெயிட் வெயிட் அஸ்வின் வெயிட் வெயிட் லெட் லெட் யூ டெல் தென் யூ கேன் அஸ்வின் வெயிட் வெயிட் லெட் ஐஸ்வர்யா ட்ரை டெல் மீ ஐஸ்வர்யா
This setting of if any person any contributory other than other than as a member, if he is owing from the company, then such amount can be set off, and after that set off any amount only for such amount he will be liable to.
Okay, I will correct you. See, generally in a limited company there is no set off available. Okay, if the company is a limited company, there is nothing called set off. But in unlimited company, there is an option of set off. That means I am a contributory or I am a member. Okay, I am a member of an unlimited company. So I have to contribute for any liability, correct?
Yes,
sir. So there is if for example company has to pay me, I have to pay to the company.
Yes, sir.
We can knock it off this in an unlimited company. But in a limited company, first I should give to the company.
Okay.
Whether the company is going to give me or not, whether I am a creditor, I am a member as well as I am a creditor of the company, okay? As a creditor, the company has to pay me. Okay? So, company is a debtor for me. I am a creditor for the company.
Yes, sir.
I am a member of the company.
Yes, sir.
I am a contributor of the company.
Yes, sir.
Now, I have to pay any amount, I have to pay first. I cannot set it off. Please understand. I cannot
set it off. Okay. Limited company.
Exactly. So this is limited company and that is unlimited company. Understood?
Okay.
Then power to make calls. Obviously, if the assets are insufficient, I will make calls.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, okay, you can go for mute. Ashwin? Yeah. Can we summon any person if we have doubt on that person?
Yes, sir.
In case that person is having some property,
yes, sir.
Or is having piece of paper of the company,
yes, sir.
He is owing a debt to the company.
Yes.
Okay.
$299.
Exactly. Then.
You can summon to the person.
Exactly.
And then having that person having the possession of the property or a book of accounts of that company.
Hmm.
And if the liquidator have a doubt that he intended the company, then the tribunal may instruct to pay the money and assent back to the liquidator.
Okay. Manoj, study paniyada paathiya class la?
Sir, part time sir, revise panna sir.
You should do da. Come on Ashwin, you continue. Ashwin, why not you on your video?
Yes sir, I will make it so sir, for 5 minutes.
Oh, okay. Okay, Raghavi, chill. Ready, yeah, tell me. Yeah,
sir.
Okay.
299.
No, 300, tell me. Can we ask promoters, can we ask, summon them and can we prosecute them kind of?
Yes, sir. Tribunal has the right to summon any person holding property of
company. In case if they find fraud, can they be prosecuted?
Yes, they have.
Okay.
They have the power to summon and prosecute directors or the promoters.
Okay. So, can they seek any legal assistance?
Yes, sir. They have legal assistance.
From whom they can seek?
In their books of accounts.
No.
They can take legal assistance.
Aye. Stupid fellow. Somebody will call up that. Legal assistance, na, avanga varamattanga. Instead of them, their advocates will come. That is called legal assistance. Ipadi sambandhi mele books of accounts onni.
போயிருக்கோட்டுலாம்
பாத்திருக்கியா சீன் பாத்திருக்கியா சரி ஓகே சிம்பிளா சொல்றேன் ஐடில சம்மன் விடுறாங்களா கிளையண்ட்டுக்கு வெதர் யுவர் யுவர் ஆபீஸ்ல இருந்து பார்ட்னர் போறாங்களா இல்லனா கிளையண்ட் வருவாங்களா
கரெக்ட் கரெக்ட் வீ கோ
ஆ சோ தே ஆர் கிவிங் வக்காலத் டு யூ கரெக்ட்டா ஆ அது சொல்லுவாங்க வக்காலத் வாங்குறேன்னு சொல்வாங்கல்ல அவனுக்கு வக்காலத் வாங்குறீங்க நீ அப்படி அர்த்தம் ஆன் பிஹாஃப் ஆஃப் தட் பர்சன் யூ ஆர் கோயிங் தட் இஸ் கால்ட் வக்காலத் சி வக்காலத் இஸ் எ ப்ராப்பர் வேர்ட் நம்ம ஏதோ அசிவா திட்டுற மாதிரி வச்சுனா அவனுக்கு வக்காலத் வாங்குறோம் இட்ஸ் ஆக்சுவலி வெரி லீகல் வேர்ட் வக்காலத்துன்றது ஓகே நெக்ஸ்ட் விஜய் மல்யா நீரவ் மோடி UK correct ah so Raghavi also will go to UK or Dubai punjida Raghavi so what I can do
so in that case tribunal can even order the arrest by blocking my passport
exactly okay any person trying to leave India I will arrest okay then what I will do detain the person detain the person okay then
and then overriding preferential payments are so okay. In general generally we think that preferential creditors will be paid first but in this case workmen and creditors having fixed charge will be secured creditors
the word you should tell first. Okay
and that in case that fixed charge has also will pay only 5% sir
ஏய் ஏதோ உளறாத சம்பந்தமா தான் பேசாத workmen
workmen
and secured creditors will be distributed in proportion
of the amount of assets realized
sir as about the 5% I will tell you what is the 5% I will tell you wait see in adu vandu fraudulent la varum adu see if you got any loan from a bank okay in last 1 year floating charge create panni or loan vaangra on the loan ku if it is renewed also in case if you become NPA if the bank wants to recover the principal and interest maximum only 5% interest the bank can recover from you purinjida adhu yaar pota da kolapa vendidhu come on tell me what is 327 preferential payments
first we'll pay the government taxes no it is not the order
it is not the order it's everyone 5 irukum 5 or 6 irukum come on tell me everything
government taxes and then salaries of the employees but that too salaries will be only for 4 months and then ESI PF any other government dues if there are pending that will pay and then expense of investigation so all these are ranked after workmen dues and secured creditors and these guys will be paid in 30%
very good next
this is investigation
investigation expense alla da idhu ikkada irundha mudichitingla we'll continue no right it's there right
continue,
okay yeah
sir.
Then what is fraudulent preference Raghavi
sir if any creditor got fraudulent payment in the last 6 months then
by transfer of property
which is not in the normal course of business
okay
then that will be fraudulent
actually not in the normal course solla mudiyadhu even in the company is in difficult times we transfer some properties to him in settlement of the liabilities we given some properties to him movable or removable properties we transferred to him in last 6 months okay in settlement of liability please understand and another thing is we sold some assets of the company please understand there are 2 things one is against the liability we have given the assets another thing is against the we sold the assets in last 1 year please understand there are 2 things liability against settle panna 6 months
asset
ye vittaina adu 1 year both are fraudulent preference yeah tell me
such asset if it is sold in good faith then it is no problem
yeah it's sold in good faith no issue okay then
not in good faith then
issue yeah exactly
problem sir appo sir aagum issue na
void aidum adha cancel panniduvanga thirupi avanga kuduthirnu property
okay
கியூரேட்டட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் சொன்னீங்க சார்.
தென்
லெக்டிக் வந்து இது பண்றது அந்த சொன்னீங்க கிளாஸ்ல.
தென்
three that's floating charge sir. Any same bank what you told is the bank has given loan and in the last 1 year any floating charge has been created. Then the company will pay only 5% of such floating charge.
Ayyo stupid fellow, they will pay 5% interest nu sonna. 5% of the floating charge na artham
5% sorry sir,
the principal anja appo 95% write off pannanum artham nee solradha paatha. They have to pay the principal but they will not pay the actual interest. Say 12% interest not, they cannot pay 12%, they will pay only 5%. Okay, so back amount they cannot. Okay, arthadu disclaim onerous property, what is that?
If there are two companies and both of the companies are say under liquidation, and one of such company is contributory of the other company, so in such a case if the other company comes and asks for contribution, then this shares that company A owns, they can appeal, they can go to the tribunal and disown such shares. In case they disown such shares, then their liability no longer exists.
Okay.
So such dishonor, what do you say, that notice of that notice that we have,
how many days time is there for the other party to come and argue?
28 days.
Okay, then I'll go to the next person. Munish,
tribunal was not made decision of disclaiming appina that
clear sir. Appina tribunal has to decide of disclaiming. See, for example, I have a liability towards Aishwarya.
Yes sir.
Okay, I have a liability towards Aishwarya. If I am disowning that, Aishwarya can come and claim it, right?
Yes sir.
Okay, tribunal will decide whether we can disown or not after giving opportunity of Aishwarya. So Aishwarya should come and argue within 28 days. For example, partly paid up share.
Okay sir. Okay. And example sir, I kaalile sonnen illaya. Example la first company.
For example, company A limited is going for winding up. Company A has invested in company B.
Yes sir.
Company B is also going for winding up.
Yes sir.
Okay, so if company A oda investment becomes a liability because company B ku company A has to give some money now.
Yes sir.
Now my liquidator says it's actually an asset, but this asset is now created a liability. I don't want this liability.
Yes sir.
My liquidator will go and ask the tribunal. Tribunal may allow this. Asna was saying may allow this. Please understand, may allow this.
May allow this. Okay.
Okay. After giving opportunity of the B limited liquidator. Okay. Done. Yes. Arthadu polama. Yaar solinda? Monish. Monish ready?
Hello.
Monish ready? Sari vidu vidu. Harini ready? Sai Narayana ready? Who is ready? Sai Narayana?
Yeah. Yeah.
Harini, okay. Harini, idhu video on panniko.
Sir, my webcam has a problem.
Idhe solrenu nee. Phone la paakuriya edhula paakuriya nee?
Laptop sir.
Nee naadhen phone la paaru. Okay. Sai Narayana.
Oh yes.
On your video.
Yes, sir.
See, I want to see whether you are telling from seeing the book or without seeing the book. அதனால தான் நான் ஆன் பண்ண சொல்றேன் வீடியோ.
Okay.
Okay. Now, offense by officers of the company in liquidation. What kind of offense they will do? They may not disclose that they hold the assets of the company. Kind of. Come on, tell me. They would have created a charges.
Yeah, so I'll be telling from the starting, sir. So following of the offences which are like basically not editing after the winding of the or application. First one is if they fail to provide the.
Okay, keep the mic near your. Mic pakkathula vechuko, vaai pakkathula vechuko. Kekkala. Oh, headphones la mic iruka?
Adha vaai la.
Sir, okay.
So first one is if the director fails to disclose all the properties to the director. Second thing is if the such director owns any properties like which is there under his control and he fails to provide the control to the liquidator. Third thing is, if he fails to, if he is entering into any charges, new charges.
Yeah, new charges created.
A new charges created.
Okay, not delivering the books of accounts, making a false entry, all those things. Okay? Then.
Enough.
Okay, can the company continue their business even at the time of winding up?
Yes, sir. If it is like supporting the winding of the business, it's like if there are any existing contracts.
Exactly. So, during that time, what the invoice should represent? What the invoice should have?
Invoice should be having
words. What word they will be having?
I forgot.
Winding up.
என்ன பண்ணனும் கரெக்டா சொல்ல ராகவி
கம்பெனி
பீயிங் வவுண்ட் அப் வெரி குட் சோ தே ஹேவ் டு ப்ரிப்பேர் அ ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் லிக்விடேஷன் ஆல்சோ ஓகே இன் கேஸ் இஃப் த கம்பெனி இஸ் நாட் ஹேவிங் புக்ஸ் ஆஃப் அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் ஃபார் எக்ஸாம்பிள் இஃப் த கம்பெனி இஸ் மெயின்டெய்னிங் ப்ராப்பர் புக்ஸ் ஆஃப் அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் தென் புக்ஸ் ஆஃப் அக்கவுண்ட் ஷுட் பி ஆடிட்டட் இஃப் த கம்பெனி இஸ் நாட் மெயின்டெய்னிங் புக்ஸ் ஆஃப் அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் வாட் தே ஹேவ் டு டு தே ஹேவ் டு ப்ரிப்பேர் அ ஸ்டேட்மெண்ட் ஆஃப் அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் அண்ட் தட் வில் பி ஆடிட்டட் Okay, after dissolution, within till how many years you have to keep the books of accounts?
Five years.
Yeah, 5 years. Okay, done. Yeah. So you can now go for mute. Next is Harini. You are the one who will leave. Oh, para our laptop line will leave. Today, three phone level the June lower upper. So the varasa the video or varasa Harinra. When the ten is sold, video or when the ten is sold. ஹரிணி
வந்துட்டியா
இப்ப போன்ல வந்தியா நீ லேப்டாப்ல இருந்து போயிட்டு ஓகே ஓகே நவ கம் ஆன் டெல் மீ ஹரிணி தி நெக்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன் இஸ் டெல் மீ அபௌட் லிக்விடேஷன் டிவிடெண்ட் அவ்வளோலாம் சொல்லக்கூடாது இட்ஸ் வெரி சிம்பிள் இஃப் ஐ எம் செல்லிங் தி அசட்ஸ் அண்ட் செட்டிலிங் ஆல் தி லயபிலிட்டிஸ் ஸ்டில் ஐ ஹாவ் அ சர்ப்ளஸ் ஆஃப் அசட்ஸ் ஓவர் தி லயபிலிட்டிஸ் ஸோ ஐ வில் கிவ் இட் பேக் டு தி ஷேர் ஹோல்டர்ஸ் தட்ஸ் கால் லிக்விடேட்டட் டிவிடெண்ட் ஓகே தட்ஸ் கால் லிக்விடேஷன் டிவிடெண்ட் நத்திங் மோர் தன் தட் தட்ஸ் ஆல் சிம்பிள் எக்ஸாக்ட்லி ஸோ ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஆஃப் ஆல் யூ டெல் மீ It's not two account, it's same account. Undistributed asset and liquidation dividend account. Per. Okay, that's how many per. Lender account is one account. Okay, now how many months we will try to distribute? Because normally we will distribute 30 days. No, here how many months we will distribute? 6 months. Arani, enna padcha Arani? Hey, Sai Kiran, vada. Arani, mute la po. Sai Kiran.
Sir.
Yeah. How many months this accounts will be there, da?
Sir, actually, we can claim for 15 years.
No, da. First, we will be paying them up to a period of 6 months. And yes, if within 6 months, if we cannot able to pay them, that means they have not claimed it. We don't know where they are. Then we will transfer to an undistributed asset account.
Yes, sir.
Okay. There we will keep it for how many period?
15 years, sir.
After that, we will be transferring to?
General revenue account.
Very good. General revenue account. Okay. That is government's account. General revenue account is government's account.
Yes, sir.
So, tomorrow if that person comes, where he will go and claim?
He can claim with the government, sir.
From the government. Very good. Then, whether the creditors having some voting rights? Hello?
Sir, sorry, sir.
Whether the creditor having the voting rights during the time of winding up?
Okay.
I am asking you, stupid fellow. Okay,
sorry, sir.
Whether the creditor is having the voting rights in Kegara?
Yes, sir, they have, sir.
See, they will conduct meetings, da. Meetings for creditors, yes, meeting for contributors, and all they will conduct.
Yes, sir.
Okay, based on the value of the debt holders, they will have the oaths.
Sir, in case of creditors voting power, whereas in case of contributors, based on the
share the
shares. Okay. Share value.
Then.
Yes, sir.
Sir, for this kind of rating, so who will be calling, who will be giving the notices and not the liquidator?
ஏய் எனக்கு நீ பேசுறதே கேக்கலடா சைனா ரேனா
for this kind of meeting
okay
who will be giving the notices and also
liquidator only that is why he is there
okay
then
you also mentioned if the liquidator is unable to then tribunal can also
tribunal will interfere yeah, exactly somebody will complain and tribunal will come that is why we have the committees and all See, if after dissolution also, within how many period, tribunal can declare the dissolution is void?
நான் சொல்லவா,
sir? சொல்லு.
2 years, sir.
2 years, good. They fraudulently given some papers and got liquidated, okay? Then
they can revise the order and...
What is the exact date of starting of liquidation, ra? Winding up starting date, na?
Date of accepting the petition is
the starting
petition
point.
Is the commencement date of
very good.
Yes, sir.
Sir, small doubt here.
Solma.
Sir. It is so practical. You tell sir the date of acceptance and date of. So for example, today my company is being wound up.
Generally, so I will tell you. Very simple. 14 days or 15 days, tribunal will take to accept you, ma. Okay. If you give the petition today. Hearing நடக்கிறதுக்கு டைம் ஆகும் ஓகே அண்டர்ஸ்டுடா ஹலோ
எஸ் சார் எஸ் சார்
சாரி ஓகே சோ என்ன ஆகும்னா இஃப் ஐ கிவ் அ கம்ப்ளைண்ட் டுடே ட்ரிபியூனல் வில் டேக் மை கம்ப்ளைண்ட் அண்ட் தே வில் கிவ் டூ ஹியரிங்ஸ் அண்ட் தே வில் டெல் ஐ அக்செப்டட் யுவர் ரெக்வஸ்ட் ஒன்ஸ் தே அக்செப்டட் தே வில் அப்பாயிண்ட் லிக்விடேட்டர் ஃப்ரண்ட்ல படிச்சிருப்போம் ஒன்ஸ் ஆன் தி அக்செப்டன்ஸ் தே வில் அப்பாயிண்ட் லிக்விடேட்டர்னு on the date the commencement of winding up
okay
here then panni accept pannuvanga
then liquidator will come he'll see what all
exactly
then
yeah.
liquidator will get the notice and then that 1 year or 2 year
exactly
process.
So all these things are in winding up okay
okay sir
so this is winding up is over okay yeah
yes sir
now what is the next chapter da
IBC sir
இருக்கிறது 10 பேரு Meena, can you tell the answers, Meena? Meena? Meena Putti, can you tell the answer? Preeti? Meena, I'm going to tell you. Preeti, can you tell me what you're saying? I'm going to tell you what you're saying. திரும்பி சரி விட்டுரு நீ கட் பண்ணு அஸ்வின் ரெடியா ஓகே அஸ்வின் ஐ வில் ஸ்டார்ட் ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி அஸ்வின் டெல் மீ வாட் இஸ் ஃபாரின் கம்பெனி டெஃபினேஷன்
Foreign company is a company which is incorporated outside India.
Yeah.
Having place of business in India itself or through agent, either by physically or electronically.
Very good. Okay. Now, there are two types of foreign company, okay? One is foreign company controlled by India, Indian body corporates, for example, Jaguar. Okay. Jaguar company should have been registered abroad, UK. And they have place of business in India, wa? They are selling the cars.
Yes, sir.
But it is controlled by?
Tata.
Indians. So if a company is 50% or more of the shares, either it may be preference shares or equity shares, but it is held by India.
Yes, sir.
Then entire Indian companies act is applicable to them.
Yes, sir.
Can you understand?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then what is another type of company where the control is not in India?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Then, so if the control is in India, then entire act is applicable. If the control is not in India, only this chapter is applicable. Go to the next section, Ashwin. Tell me, Ashwin.
Sir, I have a doubt here.
Yeah, tell me, Sainarayana.
Sir, basically told that not less than 50% is either held by Indian citizens or an Indian company.
Both.
Or by body corporate.
Yeah.
So body corporate also includes LLP, right?
Yeah.
So even if LLP holds a share, even that... That is also having the control of more than 50%, we can conclude, right?
See, I will tell you, Sainarayana, if you are holding a share in body corporate abroad, means you have to hold as per ODI.
Yeah.
Overseas direct investment. So, if LLP is allowed as per ODI, then no issue.
No issue, okay.
Okay, because there are lot of restrictions in LLP. For companies, there are many free things. But for LLP, there are not like that. Can you able to understand?
Yes, yes.
Okay, next. Hey, solra Ashwin, arthu po 380 po.
Okay, sir. Section 380, what are the documents that need to be submitted to ROC?
Tell me.
Okay, documents is a memorandum of association of the company, articles of association of the company. And the full address of the principal place of business of principal place of business.
If the memorandum and articles is not in English, what they have to do?
They have to
translate. Translated, and it should be signed by apostle.
Apostle.
Okay, what is apostle, Ashwin?
I
just like notary. Notary. Just like notary of India, we will have notary, no? Actually, I will tell you. India is for Hague Nations. India also are getting apostolization. Apostolization is done by MEA, Minister of External Affairs. It's in Delhi. So, if we send our documents with 5000 rupees, there are agencies in India, they will get apostolization for you. For example, I got apostolization. There is Sun Plaza, okay, GN Chetty Road. Sun Plaza, there is one company actually. We have to give the documents to that company. They are the official agent for apostolization. They will send it to Delhi and they will get it done. So it's not just notary, I'm telling you. Tell me.
Sir, also they ask for this, no, sir, Chamber of Commerce.
Chamber of Commerce la 200 rupees mudinjiruma.
But adhiyum kekranga sir, moonu kekranga, neenga sonna and MEA Delhi Chamber of Commerce and
Chamber of Commerce and all, if you are a member, namba subscription kattu onla 5000 rupees 6000 rupees subscription kattu poom varshathukku yearly. Mostly all the company will be member of some Chamber of Commerce, okay?
Okay.
But apostolation is taking so much costly, solla varana. Okay. Yeah, next. See, I'm just giving general knowledge. Okay, come on, next one. Ashwin, continue.
Third one is list of directors.
List of directors, secretary, their things on. Then come on.
Okay, fourth one. The name of the one or more person who are authorized to act on behalf of the company.
Authorized person, yeah, tell me. Next.
The full address of the office of the place of India, which is deemed as a place of business in India.
Very good.
And... declaration that none of the directors are not banned for the formation of the company and the management of in India.
Okay, next. Exactly, that you should tell. Yeah, if they closed, previously they came and operated and now they closed. So those things also you should tell.
Okay.
Then...
FC1
and all these things should be submitted to which ROC?
Delhi.
Delhi ROC. Yeah, Delhi ROC. And in case if there is a change, they have to again file FC2 form.
Hello.
Voice is not audible. Now?
Voice is
not. Now it's okay?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay. The network bandwidth issue. Okay, now accounts of foreign company. Tell me about that. 381. Sainarayana, Ashwin.
So the foreign company shall prepare the financial statements, which is nothing but the balance sheet and P&L as per the schedule C.
and also they should also attach the consolidated financial statement which is prepared by the parent entity.
Yeah.
If such consolidated financial statements are prepared in some foreign language apart other than English, the same needs to be translated in English and also send it to the ROC.
Exactly.
However, there needs to be other two disclosures that need to be made. One is the related party transaction as per India 24, whatever the disclosure needs to be made. And other one is
okay, leave it. Okay. There are two things. One is repatriation. Okay, so I think that's why you're confused. And the word that maybe like correct? What is repatriation? Repatriation means I earned a profit here. The abroad company came here not to serve Indians, okay? They want to earn profits. That profit they are taking back, no, that is called repatriation. Okay, yeah, that's called. Then related party transaction also you should.
Sir. Sir, is it similar to flowing back of profits?
Flowing back of profits. They are taking back, no, that is called repatriation.
Sir?
Correct, that's.
Okay, sir.
Okay, then related party transaction also you should disclose as per like AS18.
And it should be submitted to ROC within 6 months in form SC4.
Exactly, then.
Sir,
tell me.
Sir, you said you have to follow as per section 128 Indian accounting standards, no, sir. Either Ind AS or AS you have to follow, sir, for foreign company.
I will tell you. See, as per section 133,
sir.
It says if your company's Ind AS is mandatory, they have criteria, no, for Ind AS, net worth criteria is there, no. So if your company is having that, then you follow Ind AS, otherwise you follow AS. In 133, they told like this. If the Ind AS is not applicable, they can still follow 211(3)(c) of the Companies Act 1956.
Okay.
Ind AS, they are not calling us Ind AS. They are saying the accounting standard issued by central government as per Companies Accounting Standard Rules 2014.
Okay.
That is Ind AS. So they never told it's Ind AS or AS. They told whether you follow 211(3)(c) or company rules, accounts rules. Okay, then.
General criteria, which we follow for Indian companies is also...
Same thing.
I can't hear you, sir.
Same thing, I told same thing. Whatever we follow for Indian companies, same thing I told.
Okay.
Then, Saikiran, come on, tell me whether they have to put the name board. They have to put the name board. Come on, tell me the provision of the name board.
Sir, that's
for us. Hey, you foreign company, paakala. Say, ni mute po. Shivnath or Soumya?
Sir.
Shivnath, ready?
Yes, sir.
Okay, come on, tell me.
Name board should contain the company name, address, its original place of address in a foreign country. It must have its letter pad, bill book, everything must contain both the Indian company's name and its parent company's name. If it is not in English, it must be it must be translated in English.
Very good. Okay.
Then name board should be the English language and one of the reasons.
Vernacular language. Yeah, correct. Then service of notice of the foreign company.
Whatever the branches, whatever the foreign branches they're having, it should be submitted form
exactly, all the branch details they have to submit to ROC. Shivnath, come on, continue. What is the service of notice, that thing you tell me?
The notice which is served to the Indian representative as per section
383. Okay, come on, tell me, Shivnath, you tell me the starting section to this section. What is the starting section of the foreign company?
379.
Very good. 379 is what? Applicability of this active foreign company. What is next section?
380 is list of documents to be submitted.
381? Financial statements, da.
Accounts of foreign.
Financial statements.
Okay, 382.
Financial statements, then name board.
Yeah.
Then service of documents.
Very good.
Service of notice.
Very good. Then what is 384?
What are the sections which is applicable to a foreign company that is applicable for Indian companies also? 5-6 sections.
வாட் எவர் செக்ஷன் அப்ளிகபிள் டு இந்தியன் கம்பெனிஸ் அப்ளிகபிள் டு ஃபாரின் கம்பெனிஸ் சொல்லுடா.
அதாவது சார் இது வந்து
சொல்லு சொல்லு
அப்ளிகபிள் ஃபார் போத் தி கம்பெனிஸ் சார்.
சரி ஓகே விடு சோதி பிட்ட சொல்லு பரவாயில்ல சொல்லு முடி.
சார்ஜஸ்
சார்ஜஸ் சார்ஜஸ் என்ன செக்ஷன்
சிஎஸ்ஆர் ஆனுவல் அக்கவுண்ட்ஸ் சார்ஜஸ் செக்ஷன்.
சரி விடு சார்ஜஸ் என்ன சாப்டர் 6 சாப்டர். ஓகே சோ 128 சாப்டர் நம்பர் 6 then 206 to 228 inspection
investigation and
then debentures 71 annual return 92 CSR also CSR also yeah 135 so all these things are applicable to foreign companies also. Yeah, annual, exactly. Annual accounts are annual return. Actually, annual return has to be filed within 60 days of the end of the financial year of that company. It's not the March month. It's the financial year of that company, whatever it may be. It can be a December month also. Okay? Then, what is 385? I will ask Soumya.
Yes, sir.
Soldriya, Soumya?
ROC filing, sir. Company has to make payment for all this.
Exactly. Then, interpretation. What is the interpretation says?
The company which is abroad, its directors are the directors of this foreign company also. And place of business include share transfer office.
Very good, very good. Yeah. What is dating of prospectus, Soumya?
Dating of prospectus is when a foreign company wants to issue prospectus for collecting money in India, they should give the following details also along with it. Extract of memorandum, objective class, the business which the foreign company is doing, when it came to India and for how much period it is there in India.
Yeah, done.
And also principal trace of business in India.
Perfect, okay. Then, consent of expert.
388. Before issuing prospectus, they have to get a consent from the expert like CS, CMA, or any legal.
Okay, yeah. Then, if the expert has given a wrong consent, he will be liable for section 448. Within before issue of prospectus, it should be registered with
ROC.
Yeah. Then tell me about Indian depository receipts.
Indian depository receipt. A company can issue only if it is above 20 crore.
50
crore. And on final payment can
see first of all tell me about the foreign company. Don't tell about India, tell about the foreign company which can issue. What is the eligibility criteria? The pre-issue paid up capital of that company should be
paid up capital should be 50 million USD.
50 million USD. And the market capitalization should be
market capital should be 100 average for 3 years should be 100 million USD or more.
And it should be
turnover
la outre continuously traded in stock exchange. And they should have track record of distributable profits in last 3 out of 5 years. They should have paid dividends. Okay. Then the ticket size is 50 crores generally. And it can either redeem or they can 25% can be converted to equity shares. Okay. Then yeah, done. Continue about that prospectus punishment. 34 to 36. They will be punished under section 34 to 36.
34 to 36.
Okay. Normal punishment. What is a foreign company's normal punishment amount? Penalty amount.
1 lakh to 3 lakh.
Very good. 1 lakh to 3 lakh. Okay. And per day punishment is how much? 50,000 rupees per day.
20.
Okay. Done. So what is the last section?
And for officers also, there's a maximum imprisonment of
6 months. 6 months, yeah. 25,000.
Penalty ranging from
25,000 to 5 lakhs.
50,000.
5 lakhs, 25,000 to 5 lakhs.
5 lakhs, yeah.
Yeah, very good. Okay, then 393, the last section. Soumya, come on.
Contracts with
some. Yeah, come on.
If a foreign company enters into a contract with the Indian people or body corporate, and if it violates any provision of the act, it will not be considered as invalid.
Okay, very good. So that will continue. See, actually, we can sue them, they cannot sue us. Understood? Okay, then, very good. We completed today foreign companies revision. So, tomorrow we will see NCLT, all those things. See you, bye bye, good night. Keep studying the question bank, we will write this soon.
Yes,
bye bye.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir.
Yeah, bye bye.